I thought our guys competed tonight. We didn't play our best basketball throughout the course, and we missed a couple of big shots down the stretch. You know, I thought Malik's shot was open coming off the pick and roll, and just got to let it fly. We passed. I thought we passed up another one that we were open on. That where we got to just continue to let it fly and continue to believe. And you know, when you make mistakes or pass up shots down the stretch, especially, you pay for it at the other end against these guys. And so we competed. It's two games in a row, I think, two or three games in a row where they've come out in the third quarter and they've had a big third quarter against us. We just got to regroup tomorrow, watch the film, and get ready to go down to San Francisco and get a win. Our guys will be ready for game six.
Mike, James Hamm, ESPN 1320. You guys look like you were shot out of a cannon in the first quarter, yeah. And then the offense kind of stopped. Keegan Murray stopped getting touches, four or five in the first quarter. Didn't take another shot the rest of the game. What do you guys have to do to kind of keep that momentum when you get it going in the first part of a game?
We got to continue moving the basketball. You know, they've done a good job of, as the game has gone along, of sitting on Keegan and trying to not let him catch and or denying him. And so we have to keep trying to put him and Kevin and Malik in different actions to try to move him around. We've played a lot of pick and roll because we've had some success with it. But, you know, the tough part about it, you score 125, you know, a couple of days ago, and you score 116 tonight. And, you know, you hope that that's going to give you an opportunity to win the game, score 126, 127, 123. That's tough to overcome come playoff time, especially when we're not shooting the ball the way that we're capable of or that we have done throughout most of the year. So, you know, you got two guys that I thought played well for them off the bench. Obviously, Draymond is one, and Gary Payton was another. They impacted the game at a very high level. And when you have Steph and Clay and especially Wiggs on the floor, those guys are going to score. And now you get an efficient game from two guys in Draymond and Gary, and it makes it tough to overcome.
Coach Brendan Nunes, Kings Herald. To that point, somewhat, Darren was talking about how good Golden State and specifically Draymond is at playing two-on-one kind of after the initial action.
Yeah.
When it comes to defending that, what do you feel like you guys need to do to clean that up, kind of pointing towards their 60 points in the paint?
So you were talking about Draymond on offensively,
kind of after the initial action when he gets to play two-on-one.
So for us offensively?
For them offensively and you guys guarding that defense.
So meaning I'm sorry, ask the question one more time. So he was you're saying he's real tough playing 2-on-1?
That he's good at playing 2-on-1 offensively.
Yep.
And what do you feel like you guys need to do better defensively in those scenarios?
You know, it's tough because they put you in a predicament. They move so well without – bless you. They move so well without the basketball. And so Steph and Clay – just their movement alone draws a lot of attention. And when they come off the pick and rolls, if you're down the floor at all, which happened to us a couple of times, they're going to get great looks. And so what happens, it forces you to step up the floor a little bit. And if they're able to get that pass to Draymond, I mean, he's been playing that way the last 10 years. They've seen every type of defense that you can imagine. And, you know, he's making the right play. He made the right play tonight, not just for his teammates because he had 7 assists, but he made the right play for himself too. He ended up with 21 points on 8 for 10 from the floor. So we got to continue trying to mix it up. You know, we played some box and one. Maybe we may need to play a little bit more. We may need to play some zone. We may need to blitz and just rotate and live with guys shooting open shots because that's what's going to happen. Guys are going to get open shots, and at the end of the day, you got to hope somebody misses because their main guys aren't missing right now.
Coach, we've heard you talk about adversity a lot this season and how this team responds to it.
Yep.
Headed to San Francisco down 3-2, how do you think the ups and downs of this season have prepared the team for this moment, and what are you expecting to see out of them in Game 6?
You know, we've been great when our backs have been against the wall all season. you know, and so I don't see it being any different. We'll be ready for game six. Our guys know what's at stake, and we're looking forward to the challenge.
Mike, Chris Biederman, Sacramento Bee. But what'd you make of De'Aaron in the fourth quarter? He mentioned he needed to play better, not turn the ball over. Obviously, he's a guy who's probably not going to make excuses, but do you think his finger bothered him at all?
Yeah, you know, no doubt. Obviously, you know, he's showing a lot of toughness being out there in the first place. And, you know, he played 42 minutes. And, you know, the hand got hit, the finger got hit throughout the course of the ball game. But he still hung in there. And, you know, like I said, he's done it for us all year. And so whatever he feels he needs to do down the stretch or throughout the course of the ball game, we're going to ride with. So I got no complaints with the way he's playing.
Tony Harvey, NBC Sports Radio. Coach Brown, that first quarter, the Kings made 8 of 12 shots behind the arc. I think 6 of their first 8. And then things, you know, the last 3 quarters, I believe you made 2 out of 22. What was the Warriors doing to affect you guys at that three-point line?
We got the same looks, you know, throughout the course of the game. I think I said this before the game. Again, this is above my head, but analytically, prior to tonight's game, I don't know where we are now, but we've been the number one team in the playoffs generating wide-open looks from three. Now, we haven't made them, you know, but we're getting more wide open looks from the 3-point line prior to today, and maybe it's still the same. Our analytics department would have to dive into that. But prior to today, we're getting more open threes than anybody else in the playoffs, and we just haven't made them. And, you know, like I said before the game, a lot of it has to do with, you know, us trying to increase our intensity defensively. And so now we're trying to play more physical. We're chasing guys. Our intentions are a lot higher with our sense of urgency. And so there's a little bit more pressure to making a shot. And so at the end of the day, we have to keep shooting them, but they're not going in. But for sure, we're going to live with our guys shooting those things because we believe that we're going to have a game or two coming up here where we're going to make threes most of the game and not just one quarter or not just for a half.
Hi, Mike. Jason Anderson, Sacramento Bee. You talked about having your backs against the wall, and you feel like you guys have responded well in those situations. What specifically will you point to in coaching these guys up and getting them ready for Friday and you know, I'm sure you hope on Sunday to kind of rise to the occasion here and win these two ball games?
The biggest thing is if we lose, our season comes to an end. I mean, it's as simple as that, and that in itself should heighten the sense of urgency, awareness, however you want to call it, to go get it done. And I have full confidence in our guys that they'll be ready to go get it done come Friday.
All right, Coach. Mike Robertson, Sports Radio Service. So you mentioned the third quarter, but you guys came out on a 5-0 run and actually took the lead momentarily. And how much was Looney's 20-plus rebounds and Draymond getting over 20 points, how much of an effect was that, being that you know this team pretty well?
No, I mean, it's big. You give those guys credit. They had a big night for them. And, you know, they're making the right plays out there. They're coming up with key rebounds. You know, Draymond did a great job, like Foxy said, of finding the guy in the dunker when he's rolling. And, you know, you can only try to take so many things away from him, because when you do, you're going to expose yourself someplace else, and you just hope that when you do expose yourself someplace else that guys aren't making shots and or they're not getting layups or second opportunities like those two guys helped their teammates get tonight.
Mike, you've talked over the course of the year about being just honest with guys. You've also talked about in the playoffs, it's the time more to love on them than anything else. Is it more of a hindrance, or is it a little too late to pull somebody aside at this point, any player aside, and tell them, hey, we need more out of you in order to be successful? Does that do more harm than good at this point in the season?
No. You know, I've had conversations with guys telling guys that, you know, hey, we need more. We need you to rebound more. You're doing a heck of a job for us. And starting with Fox, you know, he's been obviously our best player during this playoff run. And I tell him almost every other day, you know, I'm going to keep asking you for more. I'm going to keep demanding more. And you're going to have to keep trying to produce because that's who you are. You're more than capable, and that's what you get paid to do. And so not just him, but others we've had that conversation with, because we have to do it collectively. You know, we have to have all of our guys step up, not do anything extraordinary, but they have to step up and meet the challenge. And like I said, I feel like our guys will on Friday.